It's Sports King's Best here, and we're back with another video. Last week, as you guys can tell, I didn't upload a video that week. The week before that, I uploaded two videos of the journey of Vince Carter and a predictions video. And I had some homework to do last week, so I didn't get really around to the channel. So I'm sorry if you guys were waiting for the daily upload on Wednesday. That probably won't ever happen again. I just had a lot of homework to do, but I'm back, and we're going to talk about my favorite college football team. Is it too late to solve Michigan's quarterback problem? This week, they're going up against USC, and it might be a tough test for them. The Michigan football team's quarterback competition was the top storyline of the spring. Then it extended into fall camp, and it was still up in the air this week. The game against Texas with Davis Warren, it was pretty horrible. Alex Orji isn't even playing right now, and whenever he does get on the field, it's usually just a run play. But it seems highly unlikely that the Wolverines' indecision was caused by both options being too good. As the saying goes, if you have two quarterbacks, you actually have none. Michigan coach Ron Moore announced that senior Davis Warren won the job 3 minutes before the Wolverines kicked off against Fresno State after telling the team a few days prior. Warren was serviceable that week, throwing for 118 yards and a touchdown, but he failed to consistently make plays to power. The offense, junior Alex Orji, wasn't any better as a second option. His design runs were fine, though entirely predictable, and while he threw one pass for a touchdown, he threw his only other attempt, a simple pass through the flat into the ground. If week one was uninspiring, week two was way worse. On Saturday, Texas completely exposed Michigan's quarterback room for what it is, inefficient. Warren couldn't drive his offense down the field, and the Longhorns were all over Orji's design runs. Compare that to Texas star quarterback Quinn Ewers' performance, and it's obvious why the Wolverines couldn't compete that week. After that game, Moore stuck by Warren and diagnosed many of his struggles as fixable. He didn't rule out making changes among his offensive personnel, though. He said, and I quote, "I don't want to make a knee-jerk reaction and just say something after we haven't watched the film," Moore said after getting blown out by the Longhorns. "We'll watch it, evaluate, see what we need to do, put the right people in the right places to make us successful." Even if Moore watches the film and sees a need for quarterback change, he probably won't do it because he can't do it, and he doesn't have enough talent to do it, not gonna lie. Michigan didn't bring in a transfer quarterback either time the portal was open. It set its ceiling for the season. First the lengthy competition, then the Bulldogs, and then finally Texas lowered the ceiling to a level unbecoming of the defending national champions. It's not like the Wolverines didn't know they had to fill a void at quarterback, although former quarterback JJ McCarthy remained tight-lipped about his future until mid-January. He said enough to suggest his NFL aspirations would likely win out, leaving big shoes to fill. The winter transfer portal opened on December 4th, and reports soon surfaced that Michigan was in talks with former UCLA quarterback Dante Moore. Yes, McCarthy's plans were uncertain. The Wolverines were facing multiple NCAA investigations, and former Michigan coach Jim Harbaugh was known to flirt with the NFL. But at the same time, the Wolverines were the best team in the country, and noted for their ability to develop young players and an enticing fit for any young quarterback looking for a change of pace. Dante ended up transferring to Oregon, and any other quarterbacks Michigan targeted also went elsewhere. During the spring transfer window, the quarterback market had slim pickings, and the Wolverine claims they were content with their in-house options. "That is not part of our thought process right now," offensive coordinator Kirk Campbell said after the spring game. "Roster evaluation is always part of the process, but right now that's not what we're looking at." When pressed further, Campbell stuck by his original answer and told reporters to spin the words in however you want, so here goes. "Roster evaluation at any point during the offseason should have shown Michigan that its quarterback room wouldn't cut it. If the Wolverines tried and failed to get a transfer quarterback, which they reportedly did with Dante Moore, Michigan has a program to land high-end talent, and if the Wolverines decided they didn't need a quarterback, that shows damaging complacency either way. They created an unsolvable problem at the moment." However, Michigan did beat Arkansas State, but they have USC this week, and it's going to be very tough in my opinion. Maybe they truly expected to be able to develop Orji as a passer to combine with his stud as a runner. Maybe Warren's playmaking ability will improve dramatically with more starts under his belt. But Warren and Orji should never have been Michigan's only hope. The Wolverines failed to address their glaring issues at the most important position in football. That guaranteed they won't be anywhere close to competing for another national championship this year. Unless they get the quarterback problem fixed. And I really don't think Davis Warren is going to be the answer. And hopefully Michigan does beat USC. But that's going to be the end of the video. Drop a like, comment, subscribe, turn the notification bell on, yada, yada, yada. You know the rest. And drop below what you guys want in the comments next week. And I will see you guys later.